Hi everyone. 4 hours of digging. And I have finally got to what is the leach tank. When they put it in 98, apparently, they came off the tank over there. They went out, and then they turned, and then they turned back. And now there's a big tank here. And if you look at this, see all this stuff tightly packed together? They packed that in on top of the pipe and apparently all the way around this leach bed. So that is the absolute wrong material you want to use for a leaching tank. For a leach tank, you want to use a blue stone, at least a minimum of a large number two, which is probably like this. I prefer a large, an extra large number three. Blue stone, it's crushed stone. Remember I mentioned a couple days ago about blue stone foundation for my mother's house? Same identical stuff, only this is like crashed, bang, and it's all small. Sorry, I've been digging, so I'm a little tired. As you can see, pulled out a lot of fill. Oh, just to find out where the tank is. Found a leak in that section of pipe. Could be a clog in there, but by the looks of this stuff here, I'm going to see if I can get Giuseppe to come over with his small backhoe tomorrow. Go out and cut me a little trail right around this circle, because this is a circular little unit right here. And I showed it in the last part, but it curves right around. So if I can get Joe to do me a path like about like that, width of a bucket, down about 5 feet, I'll go all the way around it, make a circle, leave the stuff in the center. But what I'll do is I'll go get the oversized number three bluestone, and I will fill it all the way around, make sure, because I don't think his backhoe will be able to lift that cap. That's a cement, probably 6-inch cap, round. So what I'll do is I'll poke all the holes, make sure it's draining. Then I'll put the bluestone all the way around it, and then a layer of topsoil on the very top of it. And as you can see, I tried to save all my sod. Got a whole bunch of it all lined up over there. Lined up all down through here. So I'll put a layer, I don't know, like that, of topsoil, and then whatever that is on top. And it's not going to be perfect, but it'll suffice. I got to see if I can get this done tomorrow, because they're talking 9 inches of snow the next day. The snow is not in any way going to affect what I'm doing. It's just easier if the snow's not there, because it's not going to freeze. It's going to be 42 degrees up here on Saturday. Even if it drops down to the freezing mark now till the weekend, this wouldn't freeze, because you have a supply that comes from the house of hot water. Wherever it gets in here, it's going to thaw out whatever's going on. And but I'm going to try to get at least the trench dug tomorrow, and I'll go up and see if I can get some bluestone. Then I can approach repairing whatever's going on with that pipe, which I believe is a split pipe. And anyway, personally, I think they sold my mother a bill of goods back in 98, and they told her she needed this fancy pants thing, which they didn't design right, and they didn't put in the right stuff so that it would drain. See that stuff right there? Once you put the scum from soap, your laundry, your dishes, once that scum gets in on the side of that, it creates like this black film that just, the water's not going to go anyplace. So basically, all this has been doing for all these years is slowly sinking down through the ground, which is not what a leach field is about. It's supposed to go out and evaporate upward. You're only supposed to have it buried about a foot underground as far as the top of your leach field. That way, as it dissipates out into the stones, it gives it room for air, and then it evaporates up slowly. It's not something that goes downward. They don't want the seepage. It seems different, but that's how it's supposed to be, so that there is an evaporation factor coming up through the ground, not saturating down through the ground. So, boring, right? Boring. But if I didn't know this, I shouldn't be doing that. And as far as I'm concerned, sold her a bill of goods. Anyway, hope to talk to you later. Hope you had a wonderful day, and see ya.